Barbara's home state of the president. And I think I just want you to know you're about to see the greatest rivalry played out here at Kyle Field, University of Texas versus Texas A&M. Every Texan lives for this day and this game. And it can be exciting, so stay tuned.
Or an Aggie. There is no in between.
This rivalry is special because it's about Texas. It's been a game for many, many years that heroes are made.
Ricky Williams runs to the Hall of Fame. Touchback. Ricky Williams, touchdown.
If you live in the state of Texas and you go to college, you either go to A&M or you go to Texas.
For more than a century, Thanksgiving weekend in these parts means one thing. The annual state championship is on the line.
It all came down to that last game when you played Texas, and whoever win that game, you know, you're going to always have bragging rights.
Aaron Glenn on an interception, and this one belongs to Texas A&M.
Every guy that plays in that game, you know, once they walk on the field, I think it hits them emotionally at some level.
Through the years, this matchup has become part of the Texas football fabric.
It's just a different kind of atmosphere when those two teams meet up.
Kickoff, Derek Johnson with the interception.
Once we hit the field, man, we just let it go.
Pitting neighbor against neighbor, sometimes even family member against family member.
In this game, it's like playing your brother, because everybody played against each other in high school, and they have respect for each other, but you don't want to lose in your own neighborhood.
The seniors know it is their last chance to etch their names into this state's rich football history.
Roy Williams is gone.
This is the last game of the year, and it's always so much riding on that game.
One last chance to become a hero in the game they spent their childhood dreaming about.
I grew up watching this game be played on Thanksgiving weekend for a lot of years.
It's like fighting the kid down the street. You know, everybody gets excited and is ready to watch that game.
Whether your colors are burnt orange and white or maroon and white, in this state, there is no single game more meaningful than Texas versus Texas A&M.
This day after Thanksgiving in College Station, Texas, a sunny, pleasant afternoon greets 82,000 fans here at Kyle Field. One of the great traditions in the Lone Star State. For the 110th time, it's the Texas Longhorns and the Texas A&M Aggies in a Big 12 South matchup. And hi, everybody. I'm Tim Brandt. This is one of those rivalries that has taken so seriously that business relationships have ended and, well, friendships have been strained for years because of their allegiance to one school versus the other. It's also been a series that has been full of surprises and upsets. I was here in 1999 after the bonfire tragedy, and Texas A&M upset 7th-ranked Texas 20-16. It's one of those games. Texas comes in again, heavily favored here today and trying to get to a BCS game. Texas A&M, with a win today, could eliminate some bad memories, bad feelings, and bad football that they played this year. A win today could set them straight. Let's bring in Ed Cunningham. Ed Cunningham, what about this? How does Texas stay focused?
Well, with so much on the line, I like what Mack Brown did earlier in the week, telling us what was on the line and then said, now, let's go play the Aggies. His coaching staff and him decided midway through the year to make a change at quarterback. Chance Mock came out and Vince Young went in. And you would expect when you put a quarterback in, you're trying to up your production in passing. But what has happened is the productivity of Texas's running game has soared since Vince Young has put his hands under center as the starter. He's averaging nearly 8 yards every time he runs the ball. And what that has done in turn is open up more running lanes for junior Cedric Benson. In the last 4 games, he's averaged over 150 yards per game. He's one of the nation's best with 16 rushing touchdowns. Now for Texas A&M, Reggie McNeil, another very talented young quarterback, the sophomore, has struggled the last 2 games against Oklahoma and Missouri. They're going to need him to be at his best like he was his true freshman year against Oklahoma when he upset the number one ranked team right here in Kyle Field. He'll have to be very good with the ball today.
For the 89th consecutive time, it's the Longhorns and the Aggies in the state championship game of Texas. The Lone Star Shootout is coming up next. Sun-drenched Kyle Field, loaded with emotion and excitement here this afternoon. 41 is here, former President George Bush Sr. As you look at Mack Brown, the head coach at Texas, won 58 games in his 6 years at UT. He's the fastest UT coach to 50, 6 straight 9-win seasons, and 6 straight bowls. However, he's still trying to get to his first ever BCS bowl. As you look at Coach Fran, Dennis Franchione, in his first season at A&M, and he was quoted as saying he didn't ride in on a white horse with a magic wand. It's a project. It'll take time. And the A&M Aggies are 4-7 and 2-5. Texas won the toss, deferred. A&M will receive the opening kickoff. So we'll get our first look at Richard McGee, and he'll be kicking to Terrence Murphy, one of the nation's top return guys. Back there with him is Jason Carter, number 7. There's a look at McGee. Everybody on their feet. A tradition here at Kyle Field. They'll stay on their feet the entire game. Longhorns 9-2. 6-1 in the Big 12 South. Lost to Arkansas and Oklahoma. And we're underway at College Station. Murphy will get a chance to return it, and he's taken down at the 12. A return of 10 yards. So Texas A&M goes on offense, and we get our first look at the Aggies' most mobile quarterback since Bucky Richardson, a 6'2 sophomore.
How you doing, Reggie McNeil? Went to school in Lufkin High School in Lufkin, Texas, and this is my first start in the Lone Star Showdown.
Number 16, Reggie McNeil, very athletic quarterback. And this 19-year-old sophomore has started 10 of the last 11 games. He continues to get better. But look out, Dustin Long surprises Texas and comes out at the quarterback spot. So this has everything in it already. And Dustin Long's pass was on the mark, but it was dropped. It was intended for Tim Van Zandt.
And Dustin Long, who played a spectacular second half against Missouri 2 weeks ago, completed nearly 80% of his passes. Reggie McNeil was ill before the Missouri game, took a shot to the head. He is healthy, but I think Long, the way that he played, I think the coaches maybe rewarded him and said, this is your time to come out and play. He's been a backup all year long behind Reggie McNeil, and I like this choice by Franchione because of the way Dustin Long played against Missouri.
Certainly is a surprise. They give the ball to Courtney Lewis, and Lewis picks up 2 tough yards. Let's take it back to Times Square Stadium. Here's John Sartre. We're glad to see John's playing hurt today.
Tape an aspirin to it, John. You'll be all right.
Out of the gun, Dustin Long. There's the swing pass, and it's dropped by Lewis. And so that's it. They'll have to punt it away. SBC starting lineups, backs and receivers. They still miss Jamar Taylor, who was injured in October. Keep an eye on Terrence Murphy, a 3-year starter, who's number 2 nationally in yards per touch. Carragher, Van Zandt, Joseph, Derek Farmer, and Courtney Lewis share the tailback duties. Offensive line, solid unit. It's been intact for 10 straight games, all 5 starters, Ruber, De La Garza, Pangartner, Kirk, and Coatser. They've started every one of the games. Jacob Young is back to punt, and Texas will start with great field position. Nathan Basher is back to receive a high punt that takes him back at the 45. And Basher taken down immediately. A 40-yard punt, no return. Byron Jones made the tackle, but still, the Longhorns will have terrific field position for their first offensive series. So we get our first look at the Longhorns offense, led by a 6'5", 225-pound redshirt freshman.
Vince Young, Madison High School, out of Houston, Texas, quarterback, first start playing Texas A&M.
Number 10 was a high school parade All-American, getting his 6th straight start. And he gives Texas almost 200 yards of total offense a game. Extremely dangerous with his mobility. He has 10 rushing touchdowns this year. Flags come in. Crowd is loud in here, and Texas knew it would be a problem.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
And Timmy, one of the things that Mack Brown and his coaching staff have instituted a little more with the ability they have now with Vince Young at quarterback is the shotgun. With a mobile quarterback like this, you put him in shotgun, it allows you to do zone reads where you can fake the handoff to Benson or hand it off. Well, that also helps you go with a silent snap count. With this kind of noise, Vince Young standing 5 yards behind his center, Jason Glenn, you will never hear a snap count from back there, so you have to lift the foot and go with the silent count.
First down and 15 for the Longhorns. still have excellent starting field position, but now need 15 for the first. Towels are waving, and Aggie fans are screaming. A little unnerving for the redshirt freshman, Vincent Young. Young keeps it and gets across the 40, but not much else. Marcus Jasmine tripped him up. The SBC starting lineups, backs and receivers. Texas is loaded, terrific skill guys. Maybe the best receiver trio in the land with Williams, Johnson, and when you have Thomas in there on passing downs, it's fantastic. Cedric Benson, a running back, four straight 100-yard rushing games. He's been on a tear. Offensive line is big. Everybody over 300 pounds except Jason Glenn. He's 275. Scott, Holloway, Glenn, Allen, and Blaylock. Holloway is the only senior. He's the leader. Here's a look at Roy Williams, the superstar, 6'4", 210 senior. Second down and 14. Five-step drop over the middle, wide open. It's caught, and look out. Thomas is gone. Touchdown, Texas. David Thomas, the tight end, slipped into the secondary by the safety and has a 60-yard touchdown for the Longhorns.
There's always, when you have a young defense like Carl Torbush, the defensive coordinator for A&M, has, there is always confusion. We saw it in practice on Thursday. They were still working on things, trying to figure things out. They were yo-yoing on that side, trying to bring Jackson Appel down and bluff the coverage on Vince Young in miscommunication. They forgot that David Thomas, the tight end, was lined up to that side, and he was running free down the middle of the field.
Well, this is an explosive offense. It averages 445 yards per game, and Carl Torbush, the defensive coordinator, knew he was up against it. They average 43 points a game, fourth best in the nation. And the extra point is good. So Pino bangs it through, and it's a 7-0 Texas lead. Didn't take long. Quick strike offense. They got by the secondary, and Thomas was off to the races. Here's a look at David Thomas, 6'3", 228-pound sophomore that made the touchdown catch, his ninth reception of the year and his third touchdown. Vince Young threw a strike to him, and it's 7-0. Two plays, 56 yards, 46 seconds, and we told you it is a quick strike offense. Offensively for A&M, it'll be interesting to see who comes out at quarterback again. The whole state of Texas has been waiting for this matchup. Vince Young against Reggie McNeil. They were the two high school seniors ranked number 1 and 2 in the state. Some had them ranked 1 and 2 in the country as high school recruits. This will be taken 7 yards deep by Terrence Murphy. Touchback, they'll bring it out to the 20. And that's where A&M will start offensively. Take another look at this touchdown. Ed, tell us what happened.
Well, you're in a cover two, and when you have cover two, the safeties, this safety has this half of the field, this safety has this half of the field. But watch as Thomas releases, the safety jumps up. You saw number four standing over there, so he has to jump. He thinks he sees something coming underneath, but he lets Thomas run right down the middle. That's just an awful error in cover two for your free safety. To not get over the top, you have to be deeper than deepest man, and that's just seeing number four out there being too concerned about him.
Dustin Long, still your quarterback, out of the shotgun, ball's tipped and almost interception. Texas defense is strong, talented defensively for the Longhorns. They're ranked in the top 25 defensively most of the season. Good front four, Crowder, Wright, Tubbs, and Thornton. The linebackers can run too, especially Derek Johnson. He is the leading tackler, All-American Butkus guy. Boyd and Harris are tough. In the secondary, Nathan Vasher is your best cover guy. He'll be locked on Terrence Murphy a lot today. Giger is the Longhorns' second leading tackler. The Texas defense has 36 sacks and 12 interceptions. Out of the gun. Long again throws. He's got it complete at the 25. Van Zandt is about 5 yards short of the first. Griffin was there on coverage and had excellent coverage.
Take a look at Texas A&M's offense against the Longhorns defensively. If there is one place where A&M may be able to attack Texas, they've been a little soft against the run. They had some big numbers put up against them early against Arkansas. That's why that number's a little inflated. But this A&M offense, very balanced. Reggie McNeil, a lot like Vince Young. They'll put him in the shotgun. when he comes in, he can run it. And Dustin Long, this guy is not a statue either. He can move around as well.
Third down and three for A&M. Murphy is the motion man. And they're going to look for him on the out. He's got it. He's got a first down for A&M. And the Aggies are on the move. Move the chains. And the Aggie fans now start at least have something to cheer about after a gain of seven.
When you go back to that game Dustin Long had against Missouri in the second half, you already mentioned Vasher, the best cover corner, is going to be one-on-one. He got caught up a little bit to the inside. Good break on the ball, but Dustin Long, when he saw Murphy come in motion to come back out, he saw that. But that game he had in the second half against Missouri, I really like Dennis Franchione going with Dustin Long because of that performance. Good decision.
Lone setback is Courtney Lewis. He's got the ball trying to get to the corner. Gets a block around the corner and across the 40-yard line. Riley got a good block for him out there. Pickup of seven. Courtney Lewis, 5'11", 191-pound redshirt freshman, top freshman scorer in the nation with 11 touchdowns, had a phenomenal game against Oklahoma State.
Five 100-yard games is one off the record of the freshman record of Greg Hill. Wanted to go to Texas with his high school teammate Vince Young, but Texas wanted him as a cornerback or a wide receiver, and he wanted to play running back.
Well, we'll see what happens here today, because Greg Hill never did lose to Texas, I don't believe. Here's Murphy around the corner. Not much there. Maybe a yard. Got back to the line of scrimmage. Not much more. Good play by Michael Huff, the safety.
And Derek Johnson over there as well. You mentioned the speed. Derek Johnson is the only guy right here that they absolutely let him roam free. He plays the weak side linebacker, so he usually doesn't have to deal with a tight end. But Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator, allows this young man all the freedom in the world. They do not try to restrict his movement, don't usually give him a gap because of his sensational sideline-to-sideline speed.
Johnson was a spy against Kansas State. Third down, they need two. They get it out, and it's complete to Farmer. There is a flag. Farmer's out of bounds, has the first down into Texas territory. Now we'll see what the flag is all about. Derek Farmer, he's well over 1,000 yards for his career at A&M, and it took him only 15 games to get that 1,000, but he's been plagued with injuries, and Courtney Lewis has been the workhorse. This is going to be holding against A&M.
The other thing I like about Dustin Long starting this ballgame is Texas spent all last week getting ready for the offense that you would call if Reggie
pass
McNeil...
On the offense... 15-yard penalty. Previous spot. Repeat third down.
So that'll make it a little bit more difficult for the Aggies. They put themselves in a hole. It's not a team that can afford to hurt itself today. You look at Dennis Franchione. Had a great talk with him after practice the other day, and he was talking about he's not a very good loser, and this has been a very frustrating year for him.
But going back to the point that him and his coaches going with Dustin Long, Carl Reese and his defensive staff at Texas spent all week getting ready for Reggie McNeil. And, of course, you're going to call the game a little bit different with a pocket passer like Dustin Long.
Third down, and the Aggies need 17. Out of the gun. Good pressure. Backside. Look out. Long's loose. Trying to get to the markers. First down, Aggies. Terrence Murphy got a terrific block. And Dustin Long is not nearly as mobile as Reggie McNeil. Picks up 18 yards.
And a really nice job of Dustin Long. His internal clock went off. Watch the late pressure coming on the blitz. He doesn't see it, but he knows 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, nothing's there. He steps up right at the last second because that corner blitz would have ear-holed him for a big loss. Nice job by Dustin Long and an excellent block by Terrence Murphy on Nathan Bass.
Not only his inner clock, I think he can feel his breath on the back of his neck. Farmer bangs his way into Texas territory up at midfield, gain of five.
But, Timmy, you said it. When you said it, it was the block downfield by Terrence Murphy. If he's not working the entire play, they would have had to punt that ball away. Great work downfield by the junior.
Good drive by the Aggies. Now moving the chains twice. They want to melt that clock, shorten the game, and keep Vince Young on the sidelines. Second down and five. Again, there's play action. And a receiver's wide open. And all the way down to the 34-yard line. Another first down for A&M. Urban Taylor somehow came all the way across the field and cleared and got free. And he's a big target at 6'3", 217.
Reggie McNeil is obviously the athlete of the bunch at quarterback. But like I said a moment ago, this is not an iron lawn deer.
Correction, it was Andy Matakis who cleared all the way across the field.
Dustin Long can move out of the pocket.
Ball's loose, and A&M gets it back. Crowder brought the pressure, and they got down on it quickly. Let's go back to New York and John Saunders. John, interesting to see where LSU goes. They could end up in the Rose Bowl.
I still think they have a shot at the Sugar.
No, I don't. Too much has to happen for them to get there. USC, Oklahoma.
We'll count out the Oregon State Beavers.
Long with plenty of time, and he closes down on him. Boy, the pressure came, and Tubbs and Thornton got there and squeezed him.
So active in the middle of this defensive front for Carl Reese. Marcus Tubbs and Roderick Wright. Both of them in the top five in tackles on this defense for Texas.
Loss of seven.
Can't pin that one on the offensive line, no. Dustin Long just had nowhere to go down the field.
Tubbs, a former tight end in high school. He is so athletic at 6'4", 310. He's a load to stop. Long steps up again, has room to run. Looking for a block. Cuts inside, and he's close to the first. He'll be about a yard short. A flag comes in late.
Think they're going to get Tydrick Riley for holding at the end of the play.
Picked up 14. We'll wait to see what the call is. And it is holding against the Aggies. You've got a wide receiver out there trying to help, trying to throw a block, and they get him for holding.
And I think they just moved themselves out of Todd Pegram
holding
field goal range.
Offense. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run. Still third down.
Pegram's career long, about 42. Now you'd be over 50. I don't know that you can try it in these wind conditions.
Well, I don't think they're thinking about that.
No.
They're still trying to get the first.
No.
And to be honest, they're in better shape than they were a minute ago.
Well, and not that you want to play for the field goal, but third and long so difficult, I would think if 7-8 yards, you'd be very happy to get back into Pegram range.
Murphy again in motion. Here comes the pressure. Set up the screen. And Texas defends it nicely. Courtney Lewis had nowhere to run after the catch. Boy, Williams and Johnson. Derek Johnson runs as well as any linebacker I've seen.
And he's put on weight. He put on about 10 pounds after last year and did not slow him down a bit.
You know, Johnson certainly was expecting McNeil to start. Johnson was the spy at K-State on quarterback L. Roberson.
And was going to be the spy again today.
And he was going to be on McNeil today, right. So Jacob Young comes in to punt. He's at midfield.
That's a costly penalty after a nice drive to get yourself out of range for the field goal because of the holding call.
Basher standing at the 15. He'll try to pooch it. This will hit at the 5, and it's like a lob wedge, 60 degrees. He had some spin on it. It's down after a 30-yard punt. Texas now will be backed up at the 5. So A&M changes the field position a little bit here.
Would have liked to have got into Pegram's range, but the penalty stopped all of that.
8-11 to play in the first quarter. Texas 7, A&M nothing. We'll be right back.
Here in Baghdad, Iraq.
Happy Thanksgiving!
ABC. Aerial coverage provided by Outback Steakhouse today. College Station dressed out in a sunny afternoon this day after Thanksgiving. Terrific, terrific day.
A little nervous that we weren't going to have the blimp today with the winds. If it was yesterday, it was the wind 40 miles an hour coming through here.
It's still blowing pretty good.
Yes, it is.
Texas backed up at the 5. First down, Longhorns. Young is your quarterback. Benson and Matthews in the backfield. This is Benson, big hole right side. And he bangs his way out for about seven. Scott Stekane made the tackle. Texas A&M runs a 4-3 scheme defensively. Ross, Jolly, Jasmine, and Smith, the only senior. Jolly, a sophomore from Houston, the top tackler on that front four. A change in the linebacker starters. Archie McDaniel got in the starting lineup for Everett Smith today. Stekane, who made that tackle, and Warren are solid. Secondary, I want you to keep an eye on number 19, Jackson Appel. He's the Aggies' leading tackler, second in the conference. He's got a Warriors mentality. This is Matthews. He's got enough for the first, so they'll move the chains. But A&M does give up over 200 passing yards per game. They have they have to tighten that up today. They've already given up the long touchdown pass to Thomas.
Speaking of their numbers on defense, let's take a look at Texas offensively. The only team in the country that averages over 225 running and 210 passing. Very balanced, but it's those running numbers that have come up with Vince Young in there. And the points, 43 per game for Texas, fourth in the country, like you said earlier. Texas A&M in the bottom 100 at Division 1A in points allowed at 38.
A lot of recognition and talking by the Longhorns. An audible and a quick drop. Young's got great feet, but he's not escaping the defense. Marcus Jasmine got there first, the junior from New Orleans.
They have talent up front. You mentioned Johnny Jolly. And Marcus Jasmine, who's just a junior, his third year as a starter, lined up right on the center. Jason Glenn. Glenn expecting help from his right guard. It was never there. Jasmine goes to where there's a hole in the protection and makes a nice play.
Loss of three. So it's second and 13. The option. Benson. Got a hold. Great pursuit by the A&M defense.
Number 32.
And there he is, number 19, Jackson Appel. We just told you about him. He's been a rock on this defense despite a number of injuries, including a shattered hand, which required surgery. But he is some kind of player.
Well, that was a nice play. But watch the left guard, Tillman Holloway. You mentioned he's the only senior. This is a veteran trick that he doesn't get called for. Boy, that's dirty. You do not dive at the back of someone's leg. If you get beat across the face, hold them, do something else, but there's no need for that.
Third down and 11 for the Longhorns. And again, it's tough to hear at Cal Field.
Look for pressure from the outside.
They bring the blitz. He picks it up and throws a strike to Roy Williams. Williams is close to the first down. Should have enough. Working on Sean Weston.
Weston giving not that much of a cushion, but you just have to be so concerned. And really nice route that time by Roy Williams as he goes to run off Weston. As soon as Weston turns his shoulders to go bail, that's right when Roy breaks it off and comes back down the stem to the ball. Good throw by Vince Young as well.
So they move the chains, first down UT. .5:15 to play in the first. This is Young on the quarterback keeper. Appel's got him. But a pretty good gainer. They pick up six. Goulin Appel with the tacklers. Boy, he is some kind of dangerous. He gives Texas 86 yards of all-purpose offense every single game. 190 yards of total offense.
And this is a play that Texas A&M saw 2 weeks ago. Faked the handoff. Vince keeps it in the guard. Tillman Holloway will pull around. They saw this against Missouri and Brad Smith. And Appel just a little bit late getting over the top from the safety spot.
Second down and a long four. Here's Young again. He's got the first down, a blocker in front of him. And still on his feet at the 45 when he's knocked out of bounds by Jones. 11 more yards.
And Linus Smith, the senior left defensive end, has to stay home. Brad Smith, again, this is the second game in a row that they have seen a very similar type quarterback and a lot of similar plays being run. And Linus Smith just, he crashed down from his end spot, and you have to stay home against a quarterback like Vince Young.
Well, Vince Young suffered three turnovers against Texas Tech, a fumble, two interceptions. Mock came in. That's what A&M was hoping for today, to force a couple of turnovers. So far, haven't been able to do that.
Well, after what Chance Mock did to Texas Tech on that last drive, I don't know which is the lesser of two evils.
Again, it's Young on the quarterback keeper after a little fake up the middle, and he picks up three or four. He's 6'5", 225-pounder. He's a redshirt freshman. You'll see a lot of him in the years to come. I was going to say Vince Young and McNeil came out of high school the same year, but McNeil was not redshirted, and he's halfway through now.
A lot of people thought maybe that R.C. Slocum should have redshirted him last year, but how can you argue with the decision to put in McNeil against Oklahoma when he won that game? But they had the luxury at Texas to redshirt this young man. But we went and visited last year before Thanksgiving, and Bill Little in their sports information department today, guys, look at that young freshman there. He's going to be awfully good.
Well, the young freshman here takes a timeout, so this will be charged to the Longhorns. Let's go down to Sam Ryan, a third member of our broadcast team. Happy Thanksgiving, Sam.
Oh, same to you, Timmy. You've been talking about Jackson Appel, the warrior. He told me he tries to hide his injuries from his mother, but he cannot hide what he's been through this season. He actually wears his brace on his left arm after dislocating his elbow earlier in the season. Then he broke his left hand. He has a 4-inch metal plate and 8 screws in his hand. He told me he sets off metal detectors at every airport. Now, Jackson writes the letter S on his hand before games. He said because in high school they used to wear Superman t-shirts, and now, hey, you can call him the Man of Steel.
No question about it. I will tell you this, too. That is one ugly-looking hand. Now, I know the doctor doesn't want me to say that. He probably thinks he's a pretty good seamstress, but that scar is nasty.
Yeah, it looked like Dr. Frankenstein got in there and did his work.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that thing.
It was the bone to his middle finger, and he said last week in practice.
Looks like the stitch in your pants.
He almost got sick when his hand... He smashed it, that hand between his face mask and another helmet, dropped him to his knees.
Well, when it was originally done, I think he told us it was like a potato chip. It just, the hand was crushed. Let's take you back to New York while we have a chance. One talented team and extremely fast. Here it's second down and 7 for the Longhorns. Young's got pressure in the backfield, but still throws a strike to Scape. And Scape has a first down at the 40. Good recognition by Vince Young and a nice pass. Just got it out there where Scape could take it and run with it. Pick up a 13. Well, a holiday tradition with a new twist. Annika Sorst right here on ABC. She can flat out play the game, I'll tell you that. Here's Benson, left side. Tries to follow Scott Holloway and Glenn right up through there, but A&M was there defensively.
You know, going back to Chance Mock and what he did last week against Texas Tech, went 4-for-5 in that final drive to get the go-ahead score against Texas Tech. And, of course, Mack Brown and Greg Davis' offensive coordinator got a lot of kudos this week for that. And they said it was actually a very easy decision because of the experience level. And it was Chance Mock who made it a great decision by how he played. And you're going to see him possibly on the next series. They like to bring him in sometime in the first quarter.
Second and 8, big hole. And Benson bangs it up in there for a first down. Terrific block by Will Matthews and a pickup of 9. You know, Texas Tech defensively dared Young to beat him with his arm, not his legs. Looked like A&M tried to start that way, but they're not having much success. Benson with a big gainer here.
And this offensive line coming into the season, that's just domination at the point of attack. There's only one senior starter, like we've been talking about, Tillman Holloway, but this group has started every game together, and Mac McWhorter, the new offensive line coach, has done a sensational job with a bunch of youngsters.
Here's Benson, right side, big hole, and again, big yardage. Picks up 7. Cedric Benson averages 5 yards a carry. Been at his best the last 4 games, as you said, 4 straight 100-yard performances. Ran for 142 yards last week.
Some pretty good names that you're talking about. Ricky Williams pops into my head. Earl Campbell, first guy to ever go over 1,000 his first 3 years.
You know what I like? He's gone 230 carries without a fumble. There he is again. Big hole straight ahead. Inside the 10. Still on his feet. Touchdown, Texas. Cedric Benson. 21 yards out, breaking tackles all the way.
There's an old rule of thumb for an offensive coordinator. If they can't stop it, keep running it. This is nothing but an isolation play to the right side. The fullback Matthews going through blocking one-on-one on the linebacker, and that right side of Mike Garcia and the center, Jason Glenn, doing a great job on the combination block.
David Pino off to the extra point attempt. Magnum's got a problem with his quad. Pino gets the kick today. And he scores his second point of the day, his first 2 points of his college career.
What year is that, Pino? I think it's a sophomore of 2001.
95-yard drive. Texas averages 43 points a game. They've already put 14 on the board here with 2:14 to play in the first quarter. Kyle Field, College Station, Texas. A young A&M team taking it on the chin here early. 13 plays, 95 yards. That drive took just under 6 minutes. And it was capped off by that guy, Cedric Benson.
A lot of youth on this Texas A&M defense. And they just got taught a lesson in basic running plays. There was nothing fancy about the running plays that finished that drive by Texas.
Terrence Murphy, number 5 right there, is the guy they want to return the ball. And he's back there with number 7, Jason Carter. This will be a returnable kick, and it will be Murphy. Now he drifts back into the end zone and takes a knee. So it's a touchback. They bring it out to the 20.
Take a look at our Dodge defensive playbook, talking about this youth. Tay-Tay Thompson is a true freshman linebacker. You've got a 3 technique lined up in the B gap. He's got to take the A gap. Watch as he drifts over the top. He never comes back to his gap responsibility. He's got to know what his gap responsibility is. Don't try to do someone else's job. You've got a 3 technique lined up to take that gap. And that's what Carl Torbush has been working so hard, is just gap control with these young players.
And now we get our look at Reggie McNeil, the 6'2", 199-pound sophomore at a Lufkin High School, Lufkin, Texas. He gives to his tailback. And Lewis is around the corner for a big gainer. First down, Texas A&M, Courtney Lewis. A gain of 13 and finally knocked out of bounds by Giger.
Can you imagine Vince Young and Courtney Lewis in the same backfield? Madison High School and Houston, Texas. That'd be a pretty scary deal. Go up against these two guys. Over 5,000 yards of offense between the two of them their senior year for. What were they, the Mighty Marlins? With Madison, or is it the Fighting Marlins?
Well, the Madison got knocked out of the state championship, though, in the semifinals, or they would have played against McNeil at Lufkin High School. This ball is knocked down by Crowder. He's 6'4". He's got a wingspan about half the size of the field. He knocked the ball down quickly.
Crowder, a young defensive lineman for Carl Reese.
He's a good one, though.
Yeah, and they saw it right from day one.
His landmark game was Nebraska.
And that was the one that Carl Reese said the light bulb went on.
Boy, he dominated in that game. And, you know, I think the true freshman really grew up there.
Yep, and that was, they had seen it in practice, and then he finally brought it off of the range and onto the field.
Play action. McNeil with time now throws out the flats. He's got it complete at the 35-yard line. So Germany makes his first catch of the game and pick up 5.
McNeil standing in the pocket. Pretty good shot in the midsection there by Roderick Wright. Really talented sophomore defensive tackle. Very active in the middle for Texas.
You know what's a shame for McNeil is the fact that he doesn't have Jamar Taylor in there. The loss of Taylor was huge and tragic for Jamar, a fifth-year senior. He was one of the best receivers in the conference and assaulting the record books. McNeil in trouble now, rolls and throws a dangerous pass, but Murphy's got it inside the 30. Terrence Murphy with a great catch, and how about that athleticism by McNeil?
Terrence Murphy never gives up on the play.
Well, there's your matchup, Murphy and Basher.
Nathan Basher, right up here on the top of the screen.
Tough
that's
throw.
Difficult. Basher trying to close the distance there at the end, but ball floated a little bit. But boy, Murphy he got to the inside of Basher and just continued his route.
Floated a little bit. That was a tough throw.
Yes,
I'm
was.
Telling you, that was a great throw. Straight ahead, they go with Lewis.
And that's the matchup that a lot of people wanted to see, was Nathan Basher, who, talking to some NFL scouts, he's looking, they actually compare him to Aaron Glenn from Texas A&M, former first-round pick. But that time, Terrence Murphy, just a junior, winning the battle, got inside, and Basher couldn't close the distance.
Well, he was not among the three finalists for the Thorpe Award. The semifinalists, they took him off the list and put him back on, but he's not among the finalists. Here's Courtney Lewis around the left side, first down A&M, and the Aggies are on the move here. Courtney Lewis, Big 12's top Courtney freshman Lewis in rushing yards and touchdowns with a 16-yard gain. Eager finally knocked him out, and he comes up lifting.
And when the new staff came in, when Franchione and his staff came in the spring ball, you see him during winter conditioning, but you don't know what a young man's going to be able to do. And they already had a good solid back in Derek Farmer, and they said all of a sudden this young freshman just continued to catch our eye. Big play after big play. He's very quiet, doesn't say much, so you're not going to know about him until he gets on the field. That was the guy that surprised Franchione the most, was Courtney Lewis.
Chad Schrader, the only receiver at the bottom of the screen. Lewis is your set back, and he's the ball carrier. Looks for a block and gets down close to the six. Derek Johnson, the linebacker, made the tackle, and boy, is he active.
He took a chance and ran through.
He got help from Thornton and Tubbs.
But earlier we were talking about what they allowed Johnson to do. Instead of scraping over the top, he's going to go right underneath. And Carl Reese, this is the only guy on his defense that he allows to be able to make plays like this. Although he doesn't finish it, he slows him down in the backfield and allows his mates to come over. But that's just great speed by Derek Johnson.
Well, you've got the feeling here at Kyle Field that this drive has to end in 7 points. The end of the first quarter, Texas leads it 14-0, but the Aggies are knocking at the door. One week from tomorrow, don't miss a great college.
McNeil, who ran a 10-500 meters in high school. I wouldn't mess around if I'm Les Kenning, the offensive coordinator for A&M. Get him out on the edge to the left. Get him to the field. Drag somebody around the back of the end zone. I would not try a running play between the tackles and waste it down.
Play action to Farmer. They've got pressure. They go to the corner. Incomplete. Good pressure by Derek Johnson. Just barely overthrown.
And Derek Johnson ran right through Derek Farmer. Anticipates the snap and throws Farmer right into the lap of Reggie McNeil. I mentioned the 10 pounds that he's put on. Has not lost a step, but he's so much more powerful than he was a year ago.
Terrence Murphy all the way at the bottom of the screen. Third down and goal. This pass is batted incomplete. And Texas has made a stop. Roderick Wright got his big paw on it, knocked it down. And McNeil now starts to come off the field. The field goal team comes on.
And Les Kenning, the offensive coordinator, was saying, we've had the hardest time getting to the second part of plays. And a lot of that is because the offensive line allowing way too much penetration. Even though Roderick Wright did not beat his man, he pushed. He got too close to McNeil.
Todd Pegram comes on for a 23-yard field goal attempt in an effort to put the Aggies on the board. High snap. The kick is up, and it's good. And so the cannon goes off, and the Aggies are on the board. 14-40 to play in the first half. It's 14-3, Longhorns. The core here at Texas A&M and College Station, they've just scored. Texas leads at 14-3, but a good drive by the Aggies. They come away with three. Scoring drive, 10 plays, 74 yards, took 226. And Pegram with a 23-yard field goal. So that's your Chevrolet scoring drive for the Aggies.
Consider that a little bit of a moral victory for Texas, because A&M had first and goal. Big play by Derek Johnson, and then Roderick Wright bats it away to force the Beckham field goal.
Brown and Young are deep for Texas. This is Young at the one. Got a hold. Young's got speed across the 30 to the 31-yard line, and there is a flag down. So a good return by Selman Young, and we'll see what the flag is all about. Texas just having its way.
Mm-hmm. Good to have Selman Young back for Mack Brown. He was legal block in the back.
So this will back the Longhorns up a little bit.
But Selman Young was bothered by a hip and a groin. He couldn't push off.
In the back. Receiving team. At the distance. Penalty. First down.
There's Mack Brown. He's not happy with that. This is his sixth state championship game, and Mack is 4-1 against the Aggies. Here's your Aflac trivia question. With 110 meetings in the Texas-Texas A&M rivalry, a tie with Nebraska and Kansas for third most played rivalry in Division 1A, what is the most played rivalry?
Can I give a hint?
Sure.
Both our mascots are rodents.
This is Benson. No. Kept by Young, and Young puts it on the ground, and A&M's got it. Vince Young fumbled, and the Aggies come up with it.
Well, you mentioned Vince Young's three turnovers last week against Texas Tech. That had to factor into the decision of Chance Mock coming in to finish the last drive to lead the Longhorns to victory. And this time he does not secure the ball at all. He fakes the handoff on that zone read. It can be so tricky to see if he hands it off to Benson or not. And he never
great
got the
fake
ball. Yeah, he never got the ball locked away, though, after the fake.
See if the Aggies can capitalize on the turnover. We told you that Young had three turnovers against Texas Tech in the last game and was eventually pulled.
Get McNeil out of the pocket. Don't make him stand in there against this blitzing front of Texas.
First and goal. McNeil to throw. Looks in the corner, incomplete, and Murphy was open. Mike Williams was trying to apply the pressure, but Terrence Murphy was there. McNeil just had to lay it out there for him.
Well, and this is a naked boot called by Les Kenning. Can be a little dangerous. You fake the handoff and turn around. If someone's blitzing from the outside sometimes, if a guy like Derek Johnson, the weak side linebacker, comes on a blitz, he's going to hit McNeil right in his mouth. I would rather you sprint a guy like McNeil out so that he's facing the defense that he's going to, put a lead blocker in front of him to account for number 11. This guy can take over the game.
Second and goal out of the gun. Closing to the flats again. Inside the five.
Pass complete. Courtney Lewis.
Down to just inside the three. Actually, just inside the two, gets a great mark.
This is a good read by McNeil. He was looking for Terrence Murphy, who was running an outcut in the end zone, and Vasher had him locked up. Comes back down, and Courtney Lewis gets everything he can out of it.
Looked like his knee hit outside the three, but they still mark it inside the two. Got a terrific mark, and it'll bring up third down and goal.
They can run the option out of this, Tim, to the right, out of this shotgun.
And McNeil wants a timeout. So Reggie McNeil and the Aggies have not been that effective inside the red zone, and they certainly have had their opportunities the last two possessions. Got to come away with touchdowns here, not field goals. Well, he put it on the ground. When we come back, we'll see if the Aggies can take it into the end zone.
Was the load option where they'll bring someone in motion, block the man who's supposed to pick up Reggie McNeil, the quarterback. I don't think you try anything against these two big defensive tackles in the middle. Get this athletic quarterback out on the edge.
Terrence Murphy goes to the top of the screen. From under center this time, McNeil on third and goal. Runs the option, cuts it in, and scores. His fourth touchdown of the year. And the Aggies have closed the gap.
Give the assist to Jonte Buell, the cornerback that forced the fumble to Jackson Appel. Recovered. And then Reggie McNeil finishes it, the sophomore, with all of the speed. Good read. Pitch man was covered. They blocked the defensive end. And that's where the soft spot was in the option.
So Reggie McNeil, one of the most sought-after high school recruits in the nation, and certainly one of the top players here in the state of Texas, caps off a scoring drive that went three plays, 8 yards, and after the fumble, they put it in the end zone. Todd Pegram comes on to attempt the extra point as they help Brian Roberson off the field.
Roberson, one of the young defenders that Carl Reese has started to get a lot of confidence in, allowing him to play a lot more snaps as this season has gone on. Good play call by Les Kennon. Take advantage of the quarterback that's in there. You take Dustin Long out, you put in Reggie McNeil, and you have that option for it now.
Pegram started his career 5 for 12. He's been on fire ever since. Pretty good kicker, trying to make it a four-point game. And it's no good.
Texas has blocked 10 kicks so far this year, and there has been a lot of penetration every time Pegram goes back to kick.
Just looked like he hit it fat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think it got tipped, but there was an awful lot of penetration on the left side.
Take another look. Just hit it low.
Mm-hmm.
And pushed it.
Looks like me off the tee box.
Bad push right.
Mr. Cunningham, you're in the trees again.
Well, with 13:46 to play in the first half, 14-9 is our score. The Longhorns heavily favored, trying to get to their first ever BCS bowl game. A&M with a record of 4-7, 2-5 in the Big 12 South, trying to upset the Longhorns and put this one in the history books as one of their greatest wins ever.
This is about the time where you'd think Chance Mock would get a chance to come in the game, but I wouldn't be surprised if they go back with Vince Young to try to get that sour taste out of his mouth because of the fumble.
Selvin Young and Gerald Brown are back to return this. This will hit at the 10 and go out of bounds, and so the penalty flag, and they'll get a good mark. Boy, the kicking game hurting the Aggies here early.
That's two missing balls.
Free kick violation by rule. Be placed on the 35-yard line. First down.
Pegram just not hitting the ball well. That was not a pooch kick and not a sky kick. He just mishit it again.
Well, when he asked you the Aflac trivia question, what is the most played rivalry or the oldest rivalry? And the answer is Minnesota-Wisconsin, 113 meters.
I said they're both rodents. Is it badger a rodent? I know a gopher for sure is a rodent. I'm not sure if a badger is.
Not sure the schools want you to be calling their mascots rodents.
They are what they are.
Straight ahead they go and push it out across the 40. Cedric Benson so powerful at 215 pounds, he just pushed the pile.
Makes no bones about who his idol is. And you can tell by the hair hanging out of the back of the helmet that big fan of Ricky Williams. Of course, the NFL had to send out a memo saying it's okay to tackle guys by their long hair.
Benson with 7 carries, 56 yards, and a really nice touchdown run. Here he is. Play action. Young keeps it. Quarterback keepers across midfield. Young's out of bounds at the 45. Terrific ball handler. Went out by Jones after a gain of 11.
And this is a true read by Vincent Young. It's basically a reverse option. And once again, one of the lone seniors starting for Texas A&M, Lennis Smith, chases the ball fake. That defensive end, he's got to stay home against Vince Young.
Steve McNair is childhood sports hero, favorite cartoon character, Bugs Bunny. He was a terrific basketball player, and McNeil was a terrific baseball player. Ball's on the ground again. Benson's got it. He's got a lot of trouble. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, plus a yard. Lennis Smith and Jackson Appel tackled him finally, but that was a dangerous play on the ground once again.
Well, and this is the hard part about this play, because you're not faking the handoff. You're reading it. And Benson just smacked it right out of the hands of Young, but what a nice play by Benson. Got a lucky bounce and ended up turning it into a positive, which Could have been the second turnover in a row, but just never gave a good pocket to Vince Young. He had his hands too close together.
Benson is so quick. And with that size, what an NFL player he'll make. Three-step drop, throws the quick out. He's got it complete. Another first down for Texas. Sloan Thomas with the catch. His first.
Thomas was a little questionable before the game with an ankle, but a senior playing in his last Aggie Longhorn matchup, you had to figure he'd find a way to get on the field. Part of the unbelievable triumvirate of receivers that Texas has had for the last 4 years. Him, B.J. Johnson, and Roy Williams, the best group of receivers ever at the University of Texas.
Thomas was the high school player of the year in Houston. He now has 20 catches on the year and 2 touchdowns. First down, Texas. Young on the play action throws it out to Williams, and Williams slips the tackle and goes out of bounds at the 33.
Well, Tim, we've seen some awfully good receivers this year. We've seen Jericho Cotri from NC State, Lee Evans from Wisconsin. I mean, just go through the list of the guys that we've seen. And it's hard to kind of pick out a favorite, but watch this move at the end. He knew where Jonte Buell was set up and just faked him to the inside, came right back out to the outside.
Well, he's got a bruised tailbone. He's limping a little bit today, but he's caught a pass in 46 straight games. And he's got 2 this afternoon. Here's the quarterback keeper again on the draw. Smelled out and stopped by the Aggies. Terrific play by Chris Warren. And Young went down. Montgomery was there as well.
And here is where Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator for Texas, needs to take advantage of the fact that even though you have a third and long situation, you can still look at this with Vince Young, who averages nearly 8 yards per carry as a running down, and run a quarterback draw.
Third down, they need 7. Swing pass, incomplete. Intended for Brent Robin. And the Longhorns aren't going to get the first.
And then you're right in the range of where you have to make a choice. Dusty Mangum, who's out with a bruised or a pulled quad, and David Pino has come in, got a little bit of a stronger leg than Dusty Mangum, has never kicked a field goal in his college career.
He's about to. Here he comes.
He's got the leg. His career high at Ryder High School in Wichita Falls, Texas, was 58 yards, so he's got plenty of range.
This will be from 48 yards out for Pino. It's a quick kick, but the flags came before the snap, and it'll be delay of game, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
Aggie, offense, 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
I'm not sure Mac Brown wanted to give that away. Once the whistle blew, he should have held on to it.
No way. It was a good call. You've got a new kicker out there. Pino's got a lively leg, but it's first time kicking in a game this big. Don't blame Mac a bit for trying to quick punt, but now you just bring out Richmond McGee and line up in your normal punt.
Trying to pooch this inside the 10. And it takes a great bounce for the Longhorns. And all the way back out to the 17-yard line. Great punt.
Hopefully dangerous.
Now in the statistics, it'll only say 18 yards, but I mean, that was perfect. So McGee does his job. He backs up the Aggies. 10:45 to play in the first half. Texas scored the first 14 points in this ball game, all in the first quarter. Texas A&M now scored 9 straight, and the offense is coming back on the field. And Dustin Long, the 6'3 junior, is coming back out with him. So Reggie McNeil will take this series on the sidelines, and Dustin Long will be your quarterback.
Well, the pocket guy, may think if you're Texas, bring a little more heat against a guy like this.
Give it to Lewis, and Lewis looks for some running room. Outside the 20 to the 23-yard line, good pickup by Courtney Lewis after he adjusted his field, reversed his run.
Talking earlier about Courtney Lewis and Vince Young, the quarterback from Texas, classmates at Madison High School outside of Houston. Spent some time talking about where they wanted to go to school, but deciding that he wanted to play running back at Texas A&M.
So Long comes out, McNeil comes back in.
Is this Steve Spurrier coaching Texas A&M now?
Out of the gun. Ball's loose. That's a live ball. Texas has it. Tim Crowder forced the fumble. And the Longhorns have great field position inside the red zone.
Well, we mentioned earlier that Tim Crowder really came on strong in the Nebraska game. What an excellent job. Watch the right arm. Drop with the left arm. You sweep over the top with the right. That's how you finish the rush. That's a true freshman working on his technique. Defensive ends coach Hardy McCrary obviously has taught that young man well. That is really nice technique how to finish that rush.
Well, and Texas has been very efficient in the red zone, scoring 49 of their 55 trips. Straight ahead they go. 32 touchdowns in there. Cedric Benson with the carry.
One thing A&M, through a very difficult season that they have really struggled with, is the turnovers.
Bo Scape comes into the game. David Thomas goes out as you look at the turnover margin. And Texas has turned it over five times in the red zone, but outside of that, they've been unbelievably efficient. Cedric Benson still on his feet inside the 5 to the 2.
Yeah, I'd say this guy's pretty strong in his lower body, Tim.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah,
how about the balance?
This is pretty amazing. He's running through the arm tackle of Justin Warren, another young linebacker. Still trying to find his way. Boy, that's good running. The left hand down, and you're seeing these little technique things. A running back, that's what you taught. Get that offhand down. We just saw Crowder finish his rush.
That was cool tackling there, too.
Yes, it was.
Out of the power eye, Thomas in motion. They go that way with Benson. He's to the one and taken down at the one by Jackson Appel.
Now that's a tackle. Jackson Appel needs to hold a class for some of these young guys, because this is a free safety. He's the leading tackler at Texas A&M, maybe come today the best ever defensive back tackler in a single season at Texas A&M. Wrapped up, drove his hips. That's a good finish. Giving up some weight to a running back who has a head of steam. You can't do any better than that if you're a free safety.
Second and goal, straight ahead. Touchdown, Texas. Vince Young. So McNeil turns the ball over, and Texas scores almost immediately. And Young's slow getting up. Another look at the touchdown.
Good finish. There was good penetration by the maroon jerseys. Young ran into the back of Jason Glenn at center and then had to get in the side. He got hit in the back by his fullback, Matthews. I'm wondering if that's the hit.
He also got bent funny.
As he got stuck.
Watch this, they pulled him backwards.
Mm-hmm. Well, your lower body is stuck in that pile. And all those maroon jerseys grabbing it up around his neck and his shoulder pads, twisting him back. And now Texas going for two.
Chance Mock is your quarterback, number 5.
I know it's early, but I've always been against this. And I know the card says go for two, up 11, but I just think it's too early in the game.
5-step drop, looks to the outside. Incomplete. Texas fans wanted an intercept in their interference call. It was intended for Selvin Young, and Jones looked like he grabbed him, but no flags.
I don't know if that ball was catchable. I've just always been a fan. Just put the points on the board. Wait until the late third or fourth quarter to start figuring out when you need to go for two.
Well, David Thomas on a 60-yard touchdown pass from Young made it 7-0 Texas. Then Benson from 21 yards out made it 14-0. Now Young on the quarterback snake makes it 20-9 Longhorns. Vince Young in there still has the medical staff working on him, trying to loosen the back. He's been doing stretches, and they continue to try to stretch out the back. Looked like he injured it on the quarterback sneak. And here's your workhorse. What a day Benson's having.
Great balance, great lower body strength.
And 11 carries for 73 yards.
The Ricky Williams dreadlock kit, starter kit.
This is a short kick. It'll be returned. And out. Across the 25 to the 26 goes Jason Carter. 16-yard return.
Take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. David Thomas runs right down the middle. Safety made a mistake, never rotated over back towards it. Then Cedric Benson has just been sensational after contact today, running through all kinds of arm tackles. And then Reggie McNeil, after Vince Young turned it over on the option. And then Young finishes after Crowder forced a fumble on Reggie McNeil.
Dustin Long is the quarterback for the Aggies. The give straight ahead off the right side. Picks up one, maybe two. Not much there. Wright, Tubbs, and Thornton. That is a formidable front for Texas. Hey, folks, Monday night, the nine. Farmer, the tailback now on second down. And they need nine. Lowe's got pressure. And now out of the tackle box, throws it away. Boy, Roderick Wright was coming after him hard.
Roderick Wright having a really nice ball game. So active in the middle, came into the game with 72 tackles. And I think what's going on right now, Franchione is making his decision at who's going to be in at quarterback based on the situation. Every time at the end of a play, the quarterback is walking over to the sideline, and I think they're making a decision. Are we going to go with Reggie on this play or Dustin Long? And I don't mind rotating quarterbacks, but it gets a little difficult in the guy's head if he has to think about it every time. Am I going to come back in on the next play?
Well, Long takes a timeout here with 7:32 to play in the first half. Well, we talked about the Monday night football game. How about the Monday night connection?
Now it's a Monday night. You know, it's a big game for us. We're trying to get back in this thing, and the Titans, they're trying to keep their first place spot in their division. So it's going to be an exciting game.
Well, Ray, we appreciate you being with us and your insight in this game, and good luck Monday night. We'll be watching right here on ABC.
All right, thanks, man. Say hi to all the Aggie fans out there, man. We're going to win this game. We're going to pull this
okay.
one out.
Well, they came short. Ray, they came short on the first down there. We appreciate it. 7:08 to play first half, and it'll bring up fourth down and about a long yard, maybe two, but they'll have to punt it away.
You know, when we talked to Mac Brown early in the week, he said this type of game where if I'm Dennis Franchione, you can fake every kick and everyone's going to think even if it doesn't work out, hey, at least he's being aggressive. I'd be, even though it's not good field position to try it, I don't know how much you want to be kicking to Nathan Vasher.
Jacob Young standing at the 23-yard line. Walk-on gets a high kick. This will be fair caught and then hits the ground inside the 30, gets an A&M roll and goes down inside the 25. So a 40-yard punt, no return. And the former walk-on does a nice job there.
And Jacob Young, he got a call in August. He wasn't even going to come out for the team because Cody Skates, a preseason all-conference punter from last year, had a sports hernia and had to have surgery. He's still trying to get back from that. But Jacob Young has done a really nice job. He doesn't have the leg of Skates, but he hangs the ball high, almost underkicks his coverage, and they're one of the best in the country, Texas A&M, allowing just over 5 yards per punt return on the season.
Young's had 11 inside the 20. He's done a nice job.
Yes,
as you
he
said,
has.
Of course, Skates now just getting back. How about that? 12 runs on first down. Longhorns have first here. And now flags fly.
And that was going to be a play action pass. So Greg Davis must have seen our graphic.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Let's go downstairs to Sam.
Well, Tim, you see Vince Young is back in the game. He didn't limp off the field. The trainers took a look at him. They massaged his lower back, and then you saw him doing some stretches. He bent around like a pretzel, proving to them that, hey, he's fine. He just got a little banged up on that play, but he's back in the game now, guys.
All right, Sam, we've got 6:43 to play in the first half. Aggie defense has to hold. See the numbers on Young? They're solid. 5 of 6. Long count. Now he keeps it. And for the 13th time, they run on first down, and he's got the first all the way out to the 41-yard line. A gain of 16. Sikane made the tackle, the former walk-on. He recorded or got a scholarship around the Virginia Tech game. He makes the tackle there.
It's amazing how many times you see Vince Young run out of leg tackles. You go all the way back to that Oklahoma game. He was the lone star for Texas in that ball game. But even against that great defense, he went over 100 yards rushing, and you saw guys, every time they go to his legs, he does a really nice job of keeping his feet moving and picking up those long legs.
Here's Benson, big hole left side. He picks up a bunch. Cedric Benson is just ripping them off in chunks.
A lot of it has to do with his offensive line coming into the season.
Well, you know, early on, Texas was explosive, but really inconsistent. Then that offensive line got confidence and became a much more cohesive unit, very consistent now over the last 5 games.
And that's what Greg Davis said back in August. He said, we're going to be explosive, but we may be a bit inconsistent until this offensive line gels, and they really have.
Second down, they need 5. A&M with a big play. Matthews hit immediately. Jolly got there along with Jasmine.
One of the things that Carl Torbush has said that's been most difficult is getting productive speed on the field. Jolly did a good job of keeping leveraging his gap, but they're going to have to get some safeties bigger, move him down to linebacker, get some linebackers, and move him to defensive end in this new 4-3 scheme. Remember, that wrecking crew always ran a 3-4.
Third down and 6. Play action. Young now chased out of the pocket. The Aggies held. Not enough for the first. Singleton made the tackle. And Texas will have to punt with 4:54 to play in the half.
And that was a nice call by Carl Torbush. He brought pressure, but it wasn't an all-out blitz. He was able to play zone behind it. So when Young, when the protection that was good early finally broke down, when he rolled out, there was nobody there, and in zone, you're keeping your eyes on the quarterback, and those guys are able to come up and make the tackle.
So Richmond McGee will be punting, doesn't have a super strong leg. He averages 40 yards a punt, and he's kicking into a wind. This is a low liner, and Van Zandt will take it out of back at 14, and he is hit immediately. A 40-yard punt right at his average. And now the Aggies will have 4:15 to work with.
Well, let's see what Dennis Franchione and Les Kenning, his OC and quarterbacks coach, decide to do this time.
So it's first down, Texas A&M.
He decides to go with Reggie McNeil for this drive.
Out of the gun. Good balance by Lewis just to get back to the line of scrimmage. One of those dangerous handoffs. It didn't look like he was going to leave it there. Eventually, Lewis just took it.
Watch Larry this. Dibbles, who is trying to fight his way into that lineup with Roderick right there in the middle, and Marcus Tubbs. Penetration right from the start, and this has been the problem all year for Texas A&M. Excellent job by Courtney Lewis just to get himself back to the line of scrimmage. But if you've got guys meeting the handoff in the backfield, how successful can you be?
The option. Lewis nowhere to run. Now skirts and squirts forward for a couple. Not very effective offensively on this series.
Well, this speed from Texas now starting to take effect. Excellent job by Michael Griffin. and Thornton, because Griffin turned it back inside, able to come inside out. And Thornton, a guy who battled injuries his entire career, finally healthy for his senior year.
So it brings up third down and long. They need seven. Throws out into the flats. This is Terrence Murphy. He's got the first down. He's got blockers. And out to the 35-yard line. His third catch and a big gainer. Terrence Murphy, number three at A&M in career receiving. Picks up 17.
Just a tunnel screen. Got a really nice block. Watch the block by Jason Carter. Right there on Derek Johnson. Johnson over pursued just a little bit, but he's the guy who has to make that play. Michael Huff finally makes the tackle, but nice execution by the other receivers in that screen package.
Terrence Murphy is number two nationally in yards per touch. 21-yard average. He picks up 17 there. First down for the Aggies. Out of the gun. McNeil, absolutely nowhere to run. Look at this. Still on his feet. And he's going to lose yardage. About five.
Well, with a guy with McNeil's athleticism, you have to take the bad with the good. This one needs to be thrown away. I mean, there's just too many white jerseys in the backfield. These defensive tackles, that time it was Marcus Tubbs, they're just overpowering the middle of the offensive line for the Aggies. This, just get outside the tackle box, throw it towards the line of scrimmage, and then you've got second and 10 instead of second and 15.
You're right, that's experience. I don't think he even thought about throwing
it. No, he didn't. He had it tucked away early, didn't he?
So now they need 14 for the first. And Lewis out to the 40. So he gets nine of them back. It'll bring up third down and long.
And this has been an effective offense. I mean, take away the Oklahoma game where they never crossed midfield. But a lot of teams have that problem against the Sooners. This has been a very good offense numerically. I mean, they're averaging over 400 yards per game, and they do it because they change things up so often in formations and what they do with their quarterbacks.
So much confusion down there right now by the Aggies, and McNeil takes a timeout. He looks confused.
That's what I have.
Well, you don't want to have to use that timeout. You're in a drive situation as it is, and the only reason that's called is because of that confusion, not knowing what's going on in the formation that came out.
Well, we got a chance. Let's take you back to top.
I liked what Terry's saying about LSU, though. You and I go round and round about this. I'm not convinced that that's not the second best team in the country.
Well, there's no question the UCLA game hurt USC because of strength of schedule. UCLA struggled down the stretch.
They'll get a little bump from Oregon State.
Right.
7-4, not great, but
right now they're in.
Whew, there's if Oregon State hangs or beats, of course, if they beat them, there's no question if LSU wins. But I'm not convinced that that's the way it's going to shake out.
Third down and five. Aggies little swing pass to Lewis, and he's going to lose yardage. Smelled out by Michael Huff. He made the tackle, and they'll have to punt it away.
Texas taking a timeout wisely. They had two left, trying to save time for the drill. And now we will go on a limb here. We will see Chance Mock. He's the guy that they like to run the hurry-up offense because of the experience level.
Time now for the singular wireless poll question. Who is the best wide receiver this year? Larry Fitzgerald at Pitt, Roy Williams at Texas, Mike Williams at USC, Rashawn Woods, Oklahoma State, and Mark Clayton of Oklahoma. Now, you've seen everybody this year in person except for Larry Fitzgerald.
I think he's the best. But you know the guy that really jumped out to me that I didn't expect to be as good as he was Mark Clayton at Oklahoma. He is something special.
All those guys are pretty special.
You cannot go wrong. If you're an NFL team that needs a wide receiver.
Chance Mock warming up. Take you back in time to 1963. A little history, a little rivalry, a little tradition. One of the terrific games here. Here's Texas scoring straight ahead. They go to the flat, Texas, all Texas at that point, and then the game-winning touchdown, and Texas wins it 15-13.
Remember, Texas has blocked 10 kicks this year. This would be a time where you may want to come after one, get a bunch of momentum going into the half.
This is a high tail wagger. Selvin Young will take it at the 21 and get it back to the 25. So with 45 seconds to go, Texas has a little bit of time to move the ball after a 39-yard punt. You know, when you look at Young and you look at Mock and you look at the comparison in quarterback efficiency, it's not even close. Mock with a rating of 161, Young a rating of only 135.
And Mack Brown made it very clear that it was nothing that Chance Mock did that cost him the starting job. It was just the added dimension of the feat that Vince Young brought to this offense. And nobody will question that decision, but this young man, Chance Mock, deserves his shot at playing.
He's thrown 15 touchdowns against only two interceptions. Young taken down immediately.
Well, now you use the timeout, and I'm wondering, because of the good kick by Texas A&M, if Mack Brown says, I don't want to mess with it, a 20-9 lead, and I wouldn't blame him if he didn't. Let's see if we can't break a cheap one on a run, but let's not do anything risky. We've already turned it over in our own territory. He doesn't want to see it again. Can't blame him for that.
Selvin Young never really had a chance. He provides that great burst of speed and explosion, but they had him in the backfield. Second down and 12. Mock will try to keep it again. The Aggies are all over it. Back to the original line of scrimmage. Marcus Jasmine got there first.
And I think Mack just took that timeout, hoped for a big return, never got it, and it was a nice decision. Let's just take it to the house up 20-9.
And so that'll do it. The first half ends here at Kyle Field in College Station, Texas. Texas scored 14 points in the first quarter. The Aggies came back and scored 9, and then Young, with the 1-yard touchdown run, made it 20-9. And that's where we are at the half. Let's go down to Sam Ryan. Sam?
All right, thanks a lot, Timmy. Coach, Reggie McNeil's been moving your offense. A costly turnover, though. You've been shuffling the quarterbacks around. How do you use them second half?
Well, we'll probably do it much like we have the first half. We got a great deal of confidence in both of them. A turnover certainly hurt. It'd be a 14-9 score at halftime. But both those guys have done some good things.
Okay, thanks a lot, Coach.
Thank you.
Timmy?
All right, Sam, pretty good first half here in College Station. Texas 20, Texas A&M 9. Right now, we'll take you back to Times Square Stadium.
Vincent has been running.